Y'all ready for this?
Hey everyone, welcome to the show and minor league recaps, and it has been nuts these last 2 weeks. My name is Rev Trev, excited that you're here. If you have not hit that subscribe button, I want to encourage you to do that and hit that like button, it really helps. Just trying to pump out this fantasy football content for you. And want to say, like, this has been two crazy weeks. I didn't do a video last week because I was actually at the Vancouver Canucks home opener against the Wild. And if you haven't seen that, go check that video out on YouTube. I'd love for you to see it and has my experience there. Let's dive into the recaps. But before we do that, let's talk a little bit about the NFL. It is absolutely crazy. As always, every single week, you never know what's going to happen. For example, I'm in a survivor pool, and I'm 8-0 because everyone except one other guy picked Cincinnati over the Jets. And that makes sense, right? You should be able to pick Cincinnati over the Jets. But the Jets somehow won, and a whole bunch of people lost in that survivor pool. Thankfully, I'd already picked Cincinnati early in the year, and I couldn't pick them, or else I would have picked them too. And then you've got the Packers going in as a depleted team into Arizona, 7-0 on Thursday night, short week, missing top three wide receivers, Za'Darius Smith, Jair Alexander, Kevin King, David Bakhtiari, and all these key players, and somehow we end up winning. And that, I don't know what happened on that last play, but Kyler Murray throws it into the end zone, and all of a sudden Douglas comes up to it. It's like, I don't know, what was he doing? what was AJ Green doing? Didn't even turn around, and next thing you know, so yes, it's been exciting. I mean, if you're a Packers fan especially, it's been exciting, and Aaron Rodgers has been on fire this year. Let's not talk about week one, let's just talk about that. But this has been a year where injuries have really affected. Not every year we can say that, but it just feels like this year even more so. Let's just dive into week seven, which I call bye week hell, because it just seemed like almost all the significant players all had their bye weeks at the same time. So when we go into, we're going to go start off with minor league, because there's nothing minor about minor league. And those guys, Sean, you just like to complain, so I'll just give you some press here. And maybe it's because you won. You had 114 fantasy points against Beach Whales. That was a massive win because Beach Whales was the top team at the time. And then you got myself. I got a win. I got a win. I've got this amazing team. I'm like 0-90,000. And next thing you know, I got a win. John's Vikes. I'm sorry, bro, but thank you for the first win. Your team was terrible, but I think, again, it comes down to the bye weeks. And so I feel really bad for you, but really good for me because I this is literally my first win. So, and then Ed's Disc Golf. His team has been stacked. King Henry, we'll talk about that in a moment. Led him 116 fantasy points. Listen to this team. Derek Carr, which is not great, but he's been playing good. Cooper Kupp, Ridley, who actually played that week. Derek Henry, Fournette, who had a monster week. Swift is in his flex and got him 20 fantasy points, right? And so he's had a great team, beat the Hogs pretty convincingly there. And then the last two matchups is hooked on a Thielen, lost to the Saints, who 145 fantasy points. That's insane. Well done, Randy. Randy's back in it now, looking to do some damage. And so awesome job, Randy. And then Bo knows. Peter, you got your second win of the year in week seven, and you destroyed Beast Mode 113-64. So that just kind of set it up for week eight. And week eight was one of those weeks where there wasn't the big fantasy numbers like there was in week 7. And it's interesting that all these people had a bye week and the fantasy numbers went high. But so why is it that it dropped? It's just like a lot of defense came up and played good. But I end up losing to Blair, hooked on a Thielen, 84-81. Darnell Williams. The whole Chiefs offense is horrific and terrible. And the only people that you can play right now is basically Tyreek Hill. Kelsey was terrible in week 8. That just did it for me. So I still can't get a win. I mean, Davante Adams, COVID, and oh my goodness. It's not all about me here. So, but Beached Wales comes with a big monster win. Again, John's Vikes, man, you're struggling now. 62-111. Ed's Disc Golf, yeah, had a terrible, terrible week. 72 points. King Henry goes down with injury. And let's just talk about that injury for a moment. Because he ended up beating Tatanka. Tatanka, Sean, you want this video. You want some minor league content, but your team stinks, bro. And so if you look at it, what you had, oh, you got 24 points from Stafford and 13 points from Kamara, and the rest of your team's hot garbage. So do you want to talk about minor league more? Okay, well, Gainwell. Where's the sighting for Gainwell? Like, this is ridiculous. Sanders goes down. Gainwell's the backup. No, Byron Scott and Jordan Howard. I didn't even know Jordan Howard played in the NFL anymore. Get all the touchdowns. Even Jalen Hurts was horrific this week. So I don't blame you on that. I'm sorry. I would have done the same thing. I would have started Gainwell with confidence. But Tampa Bay just got owned on the defensive side against the Saints, which is crazy in my books. Mike Williams and the whole Chargers team was terrible in week 8. So actually your team's not bad. It's just that they were all bad on one week. So, but Ed's team had a good week, not a great week, but a good week, good enough to, well, not a good week, a terrible week, but played the second worst team in the league. So, and then the Hogs bounced back with a big win over Bo Nose, 91-77. Beast Mode almost came back and won 92. Actually, it was the other way around. Randy Saints actually came from behind and got the extra couple points and ended up winning 96-94. And so I don't think I missed anyone there. I do apologize. So let's just quickly look at the standings for a moment. Okay, so Ed's Disc Golf, yeah, goes into first. He's on a 7-game winning streak. Are you kidding me? Seven games. So I think I just spit there anyways. King Henry's down. So who knows what's going to happen with your team now. That's another thing. When it comes to King Henry being down, the guy had over 40 fantasy points over the next best running back. He was clearly going to be a fantasy MVP this season. Out for the year, basically, fantasy-wise at least. And here we are. This is so crazy, right? But now, where's he going to end up? Like, at 7-1, he's making the playoffs, probably, right? But is he going to contend anymore? And how much money are you going to put on Fab for that guy? So that's a good question to ask yourself. Beached Wales is second at 6-2, which is a really great record. Randy Saints is 5-3, but on a 4-game winning streak. So he is hot right now. And then Tatanka with a 1-game losing streak, still 5-3, hooked on a Thielen, and the Hogs are tied at 4-4. And then Beast Mode and John's Vikes. John, Beast Mode, you're on a 4-game losing streak, and John's Vikes is on a 2-game losing streak. Bo Nose and me, we're down at the, we're like trailer park awful here. And yeah, wow, that's bad. So this is what's going on in our minor league. Let us flip over to the show, the greatest fantasy league of all time, and it is competitive, people. I came out blazing, but I didn't have to because Uncle Rico had the worst bye week that I've seen in probably 10 years playing fantasy football. He only got 57 points. I had 128, and I didn't get the blowout of the week. Are you kidding me right now? You know why? Because Sheepdog, that's what I'm talking about. Sheepdog, I told you guys that Sheepdog's team is stacked, and he's going to probably win the next 4 weeks in a row. So he is on fire right now, and went 0-4, and then had 3 wins in a row, destroying Who was it that you destroyed this week? Oh, no, it wasn't. That I did have the upset of the week, because I'm in week 7. Sorry, I'm confused. Okay, Sheepdog, we'll talk about you next week as well. Week 8. Up in Adams, only had 89 points, but beat Vic's Doggy Daycare, who's in trouble as well with all his injuries with McCaffrey and all those guys going down. Judge Judy loses to Sheepdog 107-87, so that was kind of surprising how much he won by, but I mean, Judge Judy is struggling. And then Sherlock Mahomes had a monster week of 105 and beat Knuckle Draggers, who had a respectable week. Well done, Matthew. 92-105. And then it would be Dr. Z just barely lost to Ruben's People, Purple People Eaters. I always get that name wrong. I don't know. I think you got to change your name. But speaking of which, so by 3, that's a disappointing loss for our champ there. But if we go to week 8, so I would have had the blow to the week. Let's just review all results. Yeah, I won 71.3 points. Now, I just want to like clarify, it's just bye week, so I'm not really taking a lot of credit for that, and it is what it is. But week 8, we dive into week 8, and I don't want this video to be too much longer, but you've got, I played the champ, Dr. Z, and King Henry goes down, and now his chances at championship are going down in a blaze of glory. He's only got 3 wins this year. He is a bit panicking. I know he's looking for a running back. He traded for me to get Gainwell and Hockenson, which backfired. I'm sorry, Mike. I didn't know that was going to happen. I thought Gainwell, like, he had like 10 fantasy points when Sanders went down. So I don't get what's going on in Philly. We've already talked about this. But Hockenson this week got you 8.9 fantasy points. This was respectable. But I don't know. You got to have Kamara that's going to carry you. And obviously, Kirk Cousins got to play a lot better. He only had 13 fantasy points. So, but I had Jalen Hurts. He had 11 fantasy points, which is horrific in my books. And I still end up winning. I had a terrible, terrible week. But you were worse than me, so that's the only reason I got the win. And then if we go to Up in Adams, he had a respectable week of 90. Uncle Rico goes down again. Are you kidding me? You're on a 2-game winning streak. Your guys are back, and you only scored 65 points. Like, are you concerned? Because you probably should be. I'm just saying, like, I like your team and all that kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, you're on a 2-game losing streak. Like, you're probably going to make the playoffs and all that stuff. But are you going to win? Like before, 2 weeks ago, we'd be saying, Uncle Rico's probably the favorite right now to win. I don't know anymore. I'm not saying that. I'm worried about your team, man. I don't know if you're worried. You're probably just like, relax. You know, Rodgers tells us to relax. And yes, probably should. But I'm telling you, 65 points with your guys back, that's bad. Judge Judy, speaking of a barn burner, my goodness, Judge Judy loses again. Or loses, not again, but loses a close one. Literally by 79.9 to 80.22. Like, Vic's Doggy Daycare, Johnny, you came out with this monster victory. Like, you needed that win, bro, to go to 4-4, right? And then Sherlock Mahomes, well, he's in trouble. Ridley is out, and we don't know when he's coming back or if he's coming back. You have Mahomes, who has been horrific. 14 fantasy points. Are you kidding me? Lockett was decent. Swift only had 3 fantasy points. Are you kidding me right now? Schultz, your tight end, good pickup you got, only had 1 fantasy point. Sanders, 0. Like, are you kidding me? Like, oh, and this is where Sheepdog had the blowout of the week because he ended up playing you. And Sheepdog is now on a 4-game winning streak, and he is back. He looks dangerous. He could win the whole thing. I'm telling you, I've been telling you, Brian, that you've got a chance with this team. You are super stacked in my books. And the Knuckle Draggers gets the knuckles kicked out of them. And Purple People Eaters 101 to 74. So this is nuts. So let's just quickly go to the standings, and there is a 4-way tie for first place, but Up in Adams is first place with just by points 4, and then I'm second. I've moved up to second place. Are you kidding me? That is awesome. Purple People Eaters is also third, and Uncle Rio. So we're all tied for first. Sheepdog is right behind, as well as Sherlock Mahomes. So Sheepdog's on a 4-game winning streak. I'm on a 3-game winning streak. Purple People Eater's 3-game winning streak. And then we go to Sherlock Mahomes. He's only on 1-game winning streak, but we're hoping he's hoping that Mahomes turns it around. Vic's Doggy Daycare stays at 4-4. That's good news. Dr. Z has now changed his name to Cursed by Kittle. He's got so many guys out, it's ridiculous. And so we just look, King Henry's out, Kittle's out. It looks like he's back this week, hopefully. I don't even know. Oh no, because Hawkinson's on a bye week, Gronk's on a bye week. Oh my goodness, you need a tight end, bro. Oh my goodness, Russell Wilson's out. Like, yikes. Yeah, I'm worried for you, Mike. I can see why you're looking to make a deal. Just don't make a dumb deal, okay? Yeah, anyways, Judge Judy is on a 3-game losing streak. Dr. Z, I didn't know you're on a 4-game losing streak. And Knuckle Draggers on a 2-game losing streak at the bottom. So there's still a battle for the bottom here, guys. No one's actually guaranteed. There's lots of season left to play. And so I just want to encourage you, stay in it. Stay positive. Do the right pickups. Again, King Henry, who are you going to pick up for FUB? How much is those running backs going to go for? How much is Byron Scott going to go for? How much is his Nichols going for? How much is AP? And which one do you take, Nichols or AP? Because some people say it's Nichols or AP, and some people say it's Nichols. So how much do you pay for them? Do you go for both of them? Do you have any FAB left? I'm just telling you, this is the dilemma. I don't even know. Like, I'm literally telling you now, I don't know which Titans running back I would go after. So I'm not going after either one of them in the show at all. But you guys go out and fight for it, and hopefully you do well. Anyways, thanks for watching. Loving the show, Minor League. Love that you guys are in it. Appreciate you so much. And please like, comment, subscribe. Love to connect with you guys. And, of course, go Pack Go. We've got a big game against Kansas City this weekend. I hope that Mahomes keeps struggling. But we have a great defense right now. And I'm confident that we can pull off the victory. If we can beat the Cards, we can beat the Chiefs the way that they're playing. So, have a good night.